Yes.
Very good afternoon. A very large angle exotropia, that is 60 presbyopter or more, is difficult to treat with two muscle or one eye surgery, and it invariably requires 3 to 4 muscle surgery, that is including the contralateral eye. So the question arises that should we correct this deviation in one go, or should we be doing it in two stages? So keeping this in mind, we did this study in which comparison of stability of single versus two-stage surgery of large angle exotropia was done. So all our patients had an angle of more than 60 presbyopter. They had good vision and alternate intermittent exotropia. Angle constant, the angle was constant post-occlusion test, that poor fusion for near and distance. So we divided our study into two groups, single stage and two stage. In single stage, we did 3 to 4 muscle, depending upon the angle, and one of the muscle was on adjustable. In two stage surgery, we did one eye, two muscle, and the residual deviation was observed, and the surgery was, other eye surgery was planned likewise. So a total of 16 patients underwent surgery for exotropia, out of which 8 patients had to go single stage and both eye, and 8 patients underwent two stage surgery, one eye after another. In single stage group, the total amount of surgery was calculated by adding the number of recession in mm and resection in mm. All the single stage patient, one muscle was on adjustable. In two stage group, the total amount was calculated by adding the first stage number and second stage number. The second stage surgery was done after at least 2 to 3 months after the first surgery, so patient had to wait. Mean preoperative angle was 71.1 plus minus 6.2 presbyopter for single stage group, and 73.5 plus minus 5.5 presbyopter for two stage group. At the end of 2 years, the single stage surgery patient had a recurrence of 15.5 plus minus 2.8 presbyopter, whereas in two stage surgery patient had an angle of 4.75 plus minus 1.8 presbyopter. Using independent sample t-test, the difference is significant in angle correction, but the difference in total surgery done is not significant, suggesting two stage surgery is better. So various studies have shown for the stability of single stage procedure, 3 and 4 horizontal muscle surgeries are effective for correcting large angle exotropia. Higher preoperative deviation predisposed to undercorrection, and postoperative exotropic drift should be anticipated. Between 1 week and 2 months, 77% patients experienced exotropic drift, averaging 10 plus minus 9.1 presbyopter. By final follow-up, 90% patients experienced exotropic drift, averaging 15 plus minus 14.1 presbyopter. Success rates for traditional and adjustable suture surgeries did not differ significantly. Initial post-operative overcorrection of 8 to 14 presbyopter had the highest possibility of gaining successful final motor outcomes. And for two-stage procedure, the initial drift of one eye is over. The total amount of surgery was comparable in both groups. The final drift of two-stage surgery was much less compared to single-stage surgery. The second surgery was typically done around 2 to 3 months after the first surgery. So in our final comparison, in stage one, it was easy. The correction occurred in one go. The procedure got finished in one go, and if well-aligned, binocular vision got established, but its stability was questionable. In two stage, the surgery was done on two different dates. There was a wait between two surgeries, but it had better stability even at the end of 2 years. So in the end, we did find that single stage patient also had to go for second surgery maybe after 1 year or so. The two-stage surgery patient, at least till the end of 2 years, did not need any further surgery and were stable. We conclude that a very large angle exotropia should be operated in two stages for stable results in long term. Thank you.